Yo gamers, welcome to my channel. Today I will be talking about MU Legend, an official successor of MU Online. I'm sure you remember it. In this video, you are about to find out my opinion of the game and if you should play it in 2021. But before that, you can support me in the fight with the algorithm by liking the video if you enjoyed it at the end. So, I played MU Legend to see if it is worth your time. Classes. First thing that I noticed is that the classes are a little bit different from the classic version. Here we have a Blader, that is a DPS class, Dark Lord, that is a tank, Whisperer, an archer, War Mage, that was the classic Magic Gladiator and here is more like a mage, and we have Spellbinder and Black Phantom that are again some mage type classes. The character customization was pretty poor, with few options to choose from, so I won't talk about this aspect of the game anymore. I picked a Dark Lord and the game tells me to choose a buff, Command, that is more focused on defense, and Destruction, more of a DPS type. I chose the destruction path and started my adventure. Story. The game presents me a tutorial and a prologue to the story. It shows me that a demon escaped from his dimensional cell and now it will ravage the world, so I am sent back in time to stop this before it happens. I wake up in a village with my memory wiped and I start following my destiny. Story-wise, the game is not something spectacular or innovative. It is about the classic main hero that will save the universe, send back in time, stop something before it happens cliché. At least, it was voice acted and sounded okay. It is decent. Works for a game that its main focus is you reaching the endgame as fast as possible. And I mean fast, really fast. Because I got to level 40 plus in about 3 hours of gameplay. Combat. The combat of the game is what you would expect from a top-down action RPG. MU Legend offers you 5 slots on your skill bar together with your left and right mouse buttons that you can customize and choose from a somewhat poor skill tree and some little passive points that come in form of soul levels. Those will increase your HP, crit chance, crit damage, attack and things like that. You have here something called Reborn, maybe a throwback to classic MU resets, but here they are again some passive skills like the ones mentioned before. Regardless, the combat feels responsive and impactful and the skills animation are looking great. No complaints here. I enjoyed it and was really satisfying when I got into higher levels and I was destroying all the trash mobs the game threw at me. My path really felt like destruction. Gear. I liked that the gear in this game kept its original design, where if it's plus something it will shine and you have to upgrade it with blessing stones like in the original Mew. I was really glad it was the same. Also, you can see some original classic Mew set on some NPCs of the game and in the avatar shop. The items are changing their appearance when you equip and that is always a plus. Every class can choose 2 weapons type and you can customize your skills around that a bit. A thing that I dislike about most games these days is that they will give you a present that can be opened from 10 to 10 levels and it will give you really strong gear so you'll advance really fast in the game. In this example, plus 7 weapons and full set. I want to experience the journey to the endgame and I don't like it to be a rushed experience that in 5 or 6 hours I will reach that. I want to explore the world of the game and get immersed into it. I made a pact with myself and decided I won't play anymore in any games with those kind of gifts to have a proper first impression experience and not a boring auto-leveling one to the endgame. The missions. The questing in this game is somewhat generic. Like in most MMORPGs, you will go to a village or camp, take the main and secondaries from there, do them and return. Then go to the next settlement and repeat. I think about 99% of the quests were kill X amount of monsters or collect X amount of items. Between those quests I had occasional dungeons, but short ones with some trash mobs and a boss at the end. They were pretty easy and I don't remember having troubles on any instant zone. Monsters and environment. I liked the overall design of the game. It reminded me a little of Devilion in aspect of graphics and feeling. Some of the monsters and location were reused and redesigned from the classic version for this game and that was a cool thing they kept. The graphics were not that bad originally, but because my laptop is pretty shitty nowadays and I am too poor to buy a new one, I had to set the graphics to low. The atmosphere of the game is not something dark like Diablo or Path of Exile, but something more colorful despite having demons and things similar to that. Like I already mentioned, a Devilion feeling. The population of the game declined really bad over the years and I think I saw 3 players or something like that in my entire journey to level 46. Endgame. I haven't gotten into that, but from what I read and heard is your typical grinding for loot fiesta, but you have somewhat of a limited access to some of the dungeons, something like once per day. but I can't say it for sure, so don't take me seriously. Okay gamers, after all that's been said, let's check the pros and the cons. But before we do that, I want you to notice that the algorithm beast is landing an attack on this video, and the only way to defend ourselves is to drop a like shield around this video and supplying our party with comments. But the most effective spell is the subscribe button. Press it and help me to defeat the beast. And also, if you want more short videos for knowing what should you play and what to skip. And if you want me to support even further into making content, check my Patreon. Don't forget, I try games, so you don't have to waste your time. Let's check the pros. I like that the game had great classes to choose from, each with two different aspects and some customization. The gear looked awesome and it shines if you enchant it. The game felt polished and the combat was fluid. Cons. The game progression was rushed and felt easy. You can't really find the population in this game until endgame and maybe not even there. The questing was bland and generic. Fun factor. Overall, the game was pretty fun for me despite some optimization problem where the game went into Korean and I had to look on YouTube where the language setting is. But despite that, I had a nostalgia blast with all the classic new throwback mobs and NPCs, and I think it is worth your time, but not too much of it invested because of the low population. Okay, so that'll wrap it up for today. Thank you guys for watching, and see you on the next video. Have a grindy day!